Good evening. Welcome home. My name is Daniel Brower. I use any pronouns, and I am the Associate Pastor of First Christian Church of Decatur. Welcome to our 601 Wednesday check-in and meditation. Also, welcome to October. We are entering fall, the time of year where events are beginning to ramp up again, both in our community and here at the church. For example, this weekend, Pastor Paul Turner and I will be out at the toy park for the annual Blessing of the Pets. The Blessing of the Pets traditionally takes place around the feast of St. Francis of Assisi, which happens to be today. Happy Feast of St. Francis to all who observe. We call it the Blessing of the Pets, but it's more technically known as the Blessing of the Animals, since throughout the ages it's been used to bless all kinds of animals. Work animals, farm animals, whatever, St. Francis was well known for his affinity for all things creature-related. But why do we bother to bless animals? They're tools of the trade, they're food, they're creatures. What do they really have to do with our spiritual life? If you've ever been in an argument over whether animals have souls, this kind of thing might sound familiar to you. They're just animals. Why draw them into the holy? Well, there's a bunch of reasons, and it's been written on and expounded on by people much, much smarter than me. But for me, one reason to include our critters in our expression of faith, aside from why not, is because they are part of our lives. Whether it's the chicken whose eggs we eat, or the horse we ride, or the rabbits we give unwanted kisses to, these creatures make up a significant part of our lives. They take up space in our minds and our hearts, and they should. Their companionship is a gift. And because they're a part of our lives, they are necessarily included in our spirituality. Faith and practice are not relegated into a little box marked Sunday, or Sunday and Wednesday if you're feeling brave. We might think they are. We might think that we can go to church and come home and leave it there. But the things that we believe impact every part of the way that we live, from the way we treat our animals, to the way we treat our neighbor, to the way we treat our planet. And this is true whether we realize it or not. Our spirituality is part of the whole of ourselves. We were made to be part of something, something that includes the air we breathe and the actions we take, and even our furry friends, or our feathered friends, or our scaly friends, or, you know, you get the picture. The scriptures say, "The earth is the Lord's and everything in it." And this includes the whole of our lives. So, we bless our pets as a small nod to the truth that every part of our lives matters to God. There is not one thing that God looks at and goes, "I don't really need to be involved in that." Not your animals, not your relationships with others, not your voting habits, not your gender or your sexuality, not one thing. Every part of us matters to God. God made us to be one with God and one with the whole of creation. Not in a kind of unified spirit way, but in a way that honors our unique gifts within a greater whole. That's part of why this past Sunday we celebrated World Communion Sunday. World Communion Sunday was started in the 1930s as a reminder of the unity of the Christian church. A reminder that across the world, every believer shares this one thing, this one belief in a Savior that unites us, no matter what divides us. And this is the same unity that the disciples of Christ built our denomination on. It's a reminder that though we may live in different places and practice in different ways and value different things, we are all still one people. And we still owe one another compassion and respect and love. No matter how our spirituality shows up, we show up for each other. It's an important part of the way that we live. If we can acknowledge that we are one with the greater body of Christ, then we can take it one step further and realize that we are all part of each other. Thank you for letting this little virtual moment be a part of your spirituality tonight or today, whenever you're watching it. And whenever you're watching it, wherever you're watching it, I hope that you are safe and happy. And I hope that I will see everyone's beloved animals out at the toy park this Saturday morning from 10 to 12. I regret to inform you that I will not have any bunny rabbits with me, but I will have one very angry kitty cat. So even if no one shows up, we're going to bless at least one pet. And if you're not the pet type, and you would rather practice your spirituality in a more human-based setting, we would love to have you with us this Sunday. We are still going to be in the fellowship hall for this coming Sunday, and Reverend Phil Foster is going to be bringing the word, and Allison Woolridge is going to be singing a solo. It is going to be a great day. So I encourage you to join us if you can, either in person or online right here at 10:25 on Sunday morning. But whenever I see you, whether I see you, just remember, God made you special. God loves you very much. And so do I. Have a good night, everyone.